Hello all. Today let us see how to monitor the process monitoring in the Linux boxes. So we will create a template like this, and then we will create an application called as process monitoring by clicking on create application here and then giving it a name and click on add. Once that is done, we will have to go to items on the top, and then we'll have to create item. And this kind of page appears. You're going to give any meaningful name, process monitoring off. We can give process monitoring off, and then the process name, say trapper, or any particular name. If you want to use the macros, that is also advisable. And then we are going to use the Zabbix agent type. Here, the key is the most important thing. Okay, we use proc.num of the trapper or the process name. So whatever the process name is, we'll have to put it here after proc.num, and then you can keep it as numeric, and then update interval, how soon we want to monitor this. Say it is just 1 minute I'm keeping, and then in the application let us select the process monitoring. So once this is done, the item will start monitoring. Then in order to trigger the alert, we'll have to create a triggers for that. So we'll go to triggers and click on create trigger, and then we get a page like this, and then here we'll have to click on add and then select the template. Here we'll get something like this. So here we'll have to put whatever that is, the proc count minimum. We'll have to create a macro called as proc count min, or we can just write a number here directly, and then if that is less than 12. So I'll show you what this proc count min I have defined here, and then once this is done, we'll click on update. So here what happens is that as soon as it sees the number of processes is below that number, then it is going to trigger an alert. So let's go to the template here. We can see macros inherited and proc count min is 15. So this is the number that I have defined here. So I need to have 15. If it is less than 12, it is going to trigger an alert. So once I deploy this process monitoring on the Zabbix server, process monitoring date, then let us wait for that to trigger, because I'm sure the number of processes is not as high as that. So I'm expecting an error to be triggered in a minute or so. Yeah, there it is. We can see the alert for the process monitoring because the number of processes is not that high, and hence it has triggered. So this is how we can create the template, and then we can also add a particular part in the trigger that if at all it comes back to the number of the expected number of processes, then it is going to resolve on its own. That's it guys, more in the next.